Many people ask if there is any humor in the Talmud. Now, some people will say our sages were way too serious and there is hardly any humor in the Talmud. But I'm one of those people who believes that there is a lot of humor in the Talmud if you know how to recognize it. The problem is that a lot of times we don't recognize that there is some element of humor involved. I'll give you one simple example. This is actually, for those who don't know, there are two Talmuds we have. One is called the Babylonian Talmud. That's the main one. When people say that they're learning the Talmud, usually they mean they're learning the Babylonian Talmud. That's the Talmud that was finished later, and it's a much larger work. And then there is a Jerusalem Talmud, as it's called. Really, it wasn't made in Jerusalem, but it was made in the land of Israel. It's a more correct name would be the Talmud of Eretz Israel, of the land of Israel. And in this particular story, the version in our Babylonian Talmud is somewhat short. Apparently, a piece was cut off. And that's what some of the commentators actually say, because you could restore the full version based on Jerusalem Talmud. So here is how the story goes. It's a story in the tractate that deals with Purim, the laws of Purim. It's called Megillah, this tractate. And it says that a sage, actually the greatest sage of the generation possibly, or at least one of the greatest sages, he was the most important in terms of political power at least, Rabbi Yehuda Nasiya. He was descendant of the person who compiled the Mishnah. And his name was the same as the name of his illustrious, probably grandfather, right? Rabbi Yehuda Anasi. So Rabbi Yehuda Nasiya, on Purim, when it's a mitzvah to send gifts, sends a relatively minor gift to a friend of his, a friend and a student of his. And that friend answers back, according to the Yerushalmi, the Jerusalem Talmud version of that story, he answers back, Rabbeinu, my rabbi, you just fulfilled with me the mitzvah of giving presents to the poor. So then Rabbi Yehuda Nasiya sends him a really serious present with a lot of food. And then he says, okay, now, he says, Rabbeinu, you fulfilled with us the mitzvah of giving friends gifts to friends on Purim. So why do I think that there is an element of humor involved? I think that that's exactly what happened here, that the first time the present was so small that his student basically hinted to him that with this it's good enough for as a gift to the poor, but not something, you know, you, who is one of the richest, maybe the richest Jew in the world or in Israel at that time, right? Rabbi Yehuda Nasiya is called the prince. Nasi means the prince. You're the prince and you're sending me such a small gift. So then, right, he sent him a gift already as to a friend. Right? The previous gift, he says, is just like a matanot la'avyonim. This is what you give to the poor, not meshloach manotish l'reihu. So while one could try to learn some halacha from this story, I think this type of story is a kind of illustration of humor in the Talmud. I think possibly the son of Rambam, Rabbi Moshe ben Maimon, the Maimonides, his son was also a famous rabbi, not quite as famous, of course, as his father, and he brings this as an example of a type of Talmudic Agada, which is a kind of anecdote that teaches you some kind of an interesting idea, or in this case, a funny idea. Here's another type of pun, I would say, a pun in the Talmud. So we know that when we bake matzah, you have to use water that's cooled off. You cannot use water that's hot, because otherwise it's more likely that the dough will begin to turn into chametz quicker. So our sages said that you have to take the water from the previous evening and leave it at night at home where it will cool off. The sources of water, a lot of times it actually stays warmer during the night as opposed to if it would be at home. So this water is called Mayim She'lanu, the water that stayed over for the night. She'lanu. The problem is that the word She'lanu also means ours. So this is what the Talmud records. You could already guess what the story is, that the rabbi was teaching his congregants that We could only use the water for the dough for matzah. Maim shelanu. So next day, everybody stood up in long line to pick up his water. Maim shelanu, our water. So they thought that his water is the only one that's kosher. Here is another interesting example. I'm just giving you a few random examples. I've collected a few dozen of those, but I'm giving you a few random ones just to show, to illustrate my idea, what I think is different types of humor in the Talmud. So the sages of Babel, the sages of Babylonia, and the sages of the land of Israel, a lot of times their relationship between each other was kind of like today with different groups of Jews. We love each other, we're supposed to love each other, but sometimes we kind of make jokes on each other a little bit. Not necessarily that it's such a great thing, but depends, you know. So in that case, I guess they thought that it was permitted to make such a joke. So this was the joke that a sage in the land of Israel made about Babylonian sages. He said, why are Babylonian sages so well dressed? Well, that's because they don't know that much Torah, because, right, in order to get the honor, they get it from being dressed really well, because after all, they cannot really show a tremendous knowledge of Torah, so therefore they use their clothing to distinguish themselves from common people, and that's how they get their honor. Here is another interesting kind of a joke, or at least an interesting catchy phrase, an idiom of sorts from the Talmud, that a person can be judged by, it says, the following three things. Be kiso, be koso, ubi kaso. What are those three things? Kiso means his wallet, basically, his pocket or his wallet. Koso means his cup, what he drinks from. And kaso means his anger. So you could think of different interpretations of what this means, but obviously this type of a catchy phrase, the idea was that you could tell a lot about a person regarding how he uses money, what happens when he drinks his glass of wine, you know, what are his behaviors when he's slightly intoxicated, and of course, when he gets angry. I mean, every person, sometimes something can anger him, but I mean, there is a story actually about Hillel who came out, you cannot ever anger him, according to that story, but most people do sometimes get somewhat angry. We have to be honest with ourselves. Question is, what do we do after we get angry? So the answer is, some people are able to control themselves and some people are not. So that's what the third possibility is, kaso, right? To see what happens when this person gets angry. And I'm going to end at that, this short video, because I'm planning to make a longer video with a few dozen examples of these types of jokes from the Talmud. And these were just a sample few that I wanted to try first, as most people's attention span is not that long.